we're standing at the point where our running tunnels that have been driven from Limo Peninsula, where they meet the Farringdon East Ticket Hall site. So this is where our TBM Elizabeth has come to her resting place, and we're right below the Barbican London Underground station. So what you can see behind us is the main bearing of the TBM Elizabeth, and you can see outside of that the skin. So that main bearing is kind of the guts of the machine, weighs about 70 tonnes. It's the most valuable part of the TBM. We're currently preparing to send that out through Stepney Green and then dispatch it back to Germany, where it was manufactured by Herrenknect to be used on another tunnelling project somewhere else in the world. Ideally, we'd have taken these machines out in a portal or a big shaft, but unfortunately here at Farringdon, because they need to get on with their station construction, there just isn't the space to take out these components as they were assembled. So that's why we're left to sort of strip it right down to manageable chunks that can be taken back to Stepney Green in East London. So this is our TBM Victoria, or what's left of her. So this is our westbound TBM that's just completed her drive from Limo Peninsula, Canning Town, to Farringdon. My contractor are busily removing the TBM. So what they're doing is cutting up the cutter head, and what you can see in front of me here is the remnants of that cutter head that's been as it's been cut into pieces. And you can see the bulkhead behind, where the screw conveyor used to remove the muck at the bottom. Behind the circle in the middle is the main drive that turns the cutter head and gives that the power to the TBM to turn that cutter head and remove the clay as it tunnelled its way from Canning Town to here. So our contractor DSJV has been using oxyacetylene to get the really high temperatures needed, so it goes up to about 3,000 degrees in the gas torches that the experienced workforce we have use. So they use that to generate enough heat to cut through the sort of 50, 60, 70 millimetre thick pieces of cutter head. Then using this lifting beam and winches you can see above me, use that to hold those pieces and remove them away from the cutter head. There were 8 spokes of the cutter head, and they've been all chopped up into about 30 or 40 pieces, each weighing a couple of tonnes each. The gantries are pulled back in the running tunnel back to Stepney Green, and we lift them out at Stepney Green's shaft over in East London. Once they're out of the shaft, we then chop them up and send them to scrap because they don't hold much value. The pieces here in the westbound, because of the works that Farringdon are doing, they can't accommodate to taking those out without there being a lot of disruption. So once the gantries are removed, once the main drive has been removed, then we will start removing these pieces of cutter head. Once we've finished removing the TBMs, obviously creating that space where the trains will start running through, we've got to complete the first stage concrete works all the way back to Limo and all the way through Stepney Green and the stations at Whitechapel, Liverpool Street. And then we hand over to the railway systems contractor who will start fitting those tunnels out with cables and track signalling systems so that we can start operations in the near future.